in a way, it's quite simple. At the present time, those men who are in upper level, in places of power, are so rare that usually they become a clone. I mean, they adopt a masculine style of leadership, meaning they lose their own views, their own behaviors, and at the end, there is no diversity, even they are women. And my hope, and I try to observe in my study, that the younger generation is really different and stay what they are, bringing incorporate in their team, in the way they lead their team, what we call female or feminine values. I mean, maybe more emotion, the ability to listen to the others, okay, and to exert the power in a less vertical way. It is what I call a mixed leadership, you know, having in mind masculine and feminine model. And I'm sure it is also in favor of men, you know. Maybe one day they will be able to cry in a desk, you know, and it could be great. Women have a quite ambiguous relation to power, meaning the power to have the power is just not an issue, you know. They would like to have the power to exact it, to do something, you know, to change the system, to move on, not to be here like that, you know, for the attributes of power and so on. In this way, the model of masculine power is not for them. And I think it is time to change. They will exert the power to change the model of management and of leadership. And I think it could be a good thing for corporate, because in such a world, very imprevisible, with a lot of changes, the way women react with feelings, you know, with emotions, could be not a handicap, but another value. I think we need an emotional leadership now, because it is all about human. And if you don't show the example, if your values, you're not a good leadership. You're not a good leadership. You're not a good leader. So I think that before, women are viewed like maybe too weak to be a leader, and I think it is exactly the opposite now.